Welcome to the Cosplay Room, your weekly cosplay podcast presented by ZyoriTV. This is the Cosplay Room. Hello and welcome back to the Cosplay Room. How are you? How you doing? We're back once again. We're gonna go through our hosts here. We have a great show lined up for you guys tonight. We're back with Danielle Beaulieu. Danielle, how are you feeling this fine evening?
Great.
Great. Glad to hear it. And of course, we are back with Pazubi as well. Amy, how's it hanging?
I'm good, thanks.
Awesome to hear. Bonnie, how about yourself? Looking very stylish this evening.
It's awesome.
It's awesome indeed. Is that the llama hat and sunglasses?
Alpaca?
Alpaca? Is that different from a llama?
It's like cousin.
A similar one.
Cousin.
Right?
It's cousin of the llama. Right. Looking sporty, though, as always. So we've got a great show for you guys tonight. We have our guest, Tiffany Witcher, who's going to be joining us. She's known as The Karma. I think kind of collectively we may have mentioned her on a podcast in the past. I don't know. But she's quite popular. We're going to be bringing her on to talk about what it's like to be an African-American in the League of Legends cosplay world, as well as some other riveting cosplay stuff. So, guys, what's the good word this week? What did we miss? What happened in the cosplay world? Nothing.
Uh-huh. It's been a pretty inactive week for cosplay, I think.
Yeah, it sure has. We do have a couple of debut costumes. Let's go ahead and take a look at these as we start with every week. So first we have the Ghost Bride Morgana. And Danielle, do we know where this one came from? Is this from L.A.?
I don't know who it is, but it's the first one that we've all seen for Ghost Bride Morgana. So we're all pretty excited.
I think she was at LCS in Europe. That's what I heard. But I don't know who she is either.
We have no clue. This was one of those just mystery pictures that we found. We were all impressed, and we'd love to give you credit, you mystery ghost Morgana. Why do you not watch the Cosplay Room? Oh, jeez. So, it's pretty impressive. Why is this such a rare cosplay? Why is this one that we don't see too frequently?
It's pretty recent, the skin.
And I think it just came out.
But yeah, she's the first one that kind of featured.
Cool. So we have another one as well. Only two this week, and the other is right here. There she is. Now, this one is fabulously done. This is Frostblade Aurelia, and this is just a sharp-looking costume. There's no other way around it.
Yeah, it's beautiful.
Beautiful.
Yeah.
Truly a work of art. So do we know who this is and who, where this one came from? I think we actually have this cosplayer's Facebook page.
Her Facebook name is Lula Cosplay or something like that.
Yep, here it is.
French.
Oh, French. Yeah, here we have, I'm just scrolling through her Facebook now. She looks French. But that is, another one of these skins that's pretty new? Or is this one old? I'm not so good with
it's
the League skins.
For quite a while, I think. It's just, Aurelia's not a popular champion to begin with, and her skins are even less popular. Mm-hmm. Although I think this particular skin is pretty notorious for the butt
that
shot.
That
ass. That ass.
Why? What's so special about the ass?
Google it right now. Just Google it.
Just Google Frostblade Aurelia splash.
So Frostblade Aurelia ass? That's what I'm going for.
Don't even search ass
works too.
Is it just
you might
the
get inappropriate stuff if you search ass?
All right. Let's try butt. Oh, I see. Is it just because it's so tight? Oh my! Yeah, look at that.
A really big butt.
That is a fabulous butt. All right. Well, so there you go. That more motivation to cosplay Frostblade Aurelia. I'm about to buy that skin. I need to buy Aurelia first, I guess. So that's all we got this week. Of course, cosplay debuts tend to fluctuate with as events are coming out. So we have the lull weeks, but Otakon is right around the corner. What is the actual... I always forget the date of Otakon. It's not nearly as soon as I think it is. What is it, on the 10th? 9th, 10th, 11th? Is that right?
It starts the
9th. 9th? Yeah, okay. So it's that Friday, Saturday, Sunday, the second weekend in August, which is shaping up to be quite the event. We were just talking to Tiffany earlier about how much attention it's getting on Facebook already. This Otakon is set to be the biggest yet. Ladies, of the three of yous, which ones are going? Is it all three?
I'm going.
Oh man, bummer. It's not too late, Amy.
I try to like sneak my way in if Nami goes well, but I'm in the process of planning for PAX Prime at the end of August, so
yeah.
We still have a room for you. A spot.
You don't have room for me?
No, there we do have room.
Yeah, last time.
I would say you better make room for me.
It's I'm not scared. Too late. I don't know. I've never been to an Otakon. I think we talked about this a few weeks past, and I've never been quite excited. I'm ready to get some good pictures. I'm ready to stockpile. Anime Next was disappointing. I'm ready to be blown away by Otakon. You guys going to hit the raves? Get the furry legs on?
Sure.
Sure? No? Oh, yeah. I saw that for the first time, and I wasn't... I don't know. We'll talk about that later. Tiffany has done the rave thing. She knows what's good. We'll ask her all about it. Let me put that in the notes right here so I don't forget. Let's just say rave. Okay, remember, we're going to bring that up, guys. So, anything else before we bring in our guests, guys? This is our chance before we get our guest in here. We get to talk about ourselves before we have to be good Samaritans and just talk about other people. This is your chance. Anything you want to get off your chest, now's your go time before we get Tiffany in here.
I've been working on my costume.
Yeah, how's it going, Bonnie?
Pretty good. I'll show you guys.
Oh, we got progress pics. Okay, here we go.
That's the leg piece.
Very nice. Reminds me of Power Rangers.
Whatever.
It's a compliment.
Yeah, Jen's just so pretty.
So do those light up as well?
Yes, it will.
It will?
Once I painted it, I can attach the lighting onto the gem.
Awesome. Danielle, are you doing progress? Are you showing some progress tonight, or are we...
It's a secret.
Keeping progress a secret? Okay.
Yeah, but I have a lot of progress.
All right, maybe, I can get behind
maybe
that.
Maybe next Monday I'll, like, give a sneak preview or something.
A little, like, maybe, like, half of the shoulder piece and let people try and guess what costume,
yeah.
What hero it
well,
is.
I think the shoulder piece would give it away.
All right, maybe a leg piece, maybe a torso. You pick the piece.
Yeah.
Cool. Wow, I feel in the loop now. I got a little sneak peek. Wow.
Ooh. I think everybody in this room did.
Everybody in the...
I can't keep it that well of a secret.
It's true. Amy, how goes Koinami? You hinted at... I mean, is there a chance you could finish Koinami by Otakon? That's a pretty tight deadline.
No, probably not. But if I get into a good state before Otakon, I might bring Lulu. It's just like I'm worried about losing the weekend, you know? Like, I feel like it'll be around crunch time for Nami, so... I don't want to, like, commit to going and then be like, oh, crap. I'm nowhere near done, Nami, you know?
How soon is PAX Prime? Is that the weekend after Otakon?
No, PAX Prime is August 29th to September 2nd.
Okay. So, well, you got a good window, but I know what you're saying. It would suck to go to Otakon for funsies and then the big wigs at PAX Prime. You don't want to let anybody down.
Yeah.
Got to go big. I'm jealous. I want to go to PAX Prime so bad. I hear there's a lot of bums in Seattle, though.
Yeah.
Yeah, lots of bums?
Yeah.
I don't know.
It's in the downtown area, but
yeah.
It's generally okay during the day.
Yeah. Every time I hear about an event in Seattle, all of my Twitter feed at the end of the event is always, Seattle's awesome, but I couldn't live here. There's so many homeless people. And I was, oh, okay, I guess it's a... It's a pretty homeless area. I don't know. No offense, Seattle. Any Seattleians out there? I've never been. So, all right. Cool. Enough pussyfooting around, guys. Let's bring on our honored guest for the night. We have Tiffany Witcher. As always, we've got our little mashup, an overview of some of the cosplays she's done. But first, Tiffany, are you with us?
I am.
You are. Oh, very nice. All right, let's go ahead and roll your little thing here, and I'll kind of talk through it, and then we're going to go through them one by one, and you can give us the breakdown. So, wrong one. All right, here. Let's see. There we go. All right. So, as we mentioned, you are kind of known as the Karma, and we're going to ask you quite a bit about that. Here's your yukata, I believe is right, a Japanese thing. This is Rave Tiffany, which, of course, we're going to talk about as well. We've got Alara Croft here. This is the one that I was forgetting in our little bit of pregame. A fantastic.
No, I think... Huh? I think that's Lana Kane from Archer.
All right. Well, Jesus Christ, I should have asked before we started this. There's the Nick Fury as well. We're going to talk a lot about this Crossplay Nick Fury, which is another fabulous one that you did. And, of course, wrapping it up with the Karma. So, before we get too far ahead of ourselves, officially welcome, Tiffany. Thank you so much for taking the time to join us here on the Cosplay Room.
I'm happy to be here.
Absolutely. So let's start from the very beginning. Let's talk about Karma. Why Karma? Why is she your, at least in our minds, you are the go-to person for Karma. Some of us are afraid to do Karma because we don't want to step on your territory. How, I'm not going to say who, but you got a 1 in 4 chance. Why? How? How did you become the Karma, and why did you choose that champion?
When I started playing League about 3 years ago, it was after Silent, this age was Silent Night Sona. It was after that Christmas, basically, because I'm so pissed I came in right before that skin was gone. So when that happened, I was like, oh, I want to try this game, blah, blah, blah. My friends are trying, everyone else is trying. So I tried it out because I used to play Dota on Warcraft 3. Mm-hmm. And when I did that, I was like, okay, I have all these free champions, started trying champions every week and things like that. Mm-hmm. And then I was like, I have enough to buy a champion. Yay! So I was looking through the champions. And I was like, who is this? I'm a person that likes, I love elegant women. I love seeing women some kind of something there that I would like. Cause I'm into different things. Mm-hmm. I saw Karma's dress. That's the first thing I saw. And I was like, oh, I love her dress and blah, blah, blah. And then I bought her. I sucked with her so bad, and I just kept practicing and practicing. This is before the rework and all that crap, and before they, no offense, Riot, no, you messed her up. Anyway, so I was practicing all over and over again, and I said, you know what? I think if I do a League cosplay, it will be this Karma. And I had all her skins and everything, and before they announced the rework, they were talking about a new skin, Blade. I think it was like Bladecraft Karma, something like that. So I was really excited for that. But then they kind of slated it, saying that she's getting a rework. Mm-hmm. Okay. I did the Karma cosplay first last year at Otakon. That was my first year actually starting to cosplay. Mm-hmm. My first real cosplay was Lana Kane from Archer. So when I did that, I got a lot of attention for it at the convention. Like, I had guys stopping me, like, oh my God, it's a Karma. Oh my God, it's a Karma. I'm like, okay, hi. So when I was getting stopped constantly, and it was like, Karma's so rare to cosplay. I can't believe you're a Karma fan. I'm a Karma fan too.
Yeah.
Oh. That's my little guy. And yes, I am a mother. And I was like, I just love the elegance of the character.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
And her story, her lore is actually pretty darn good. Like, I had a friend who was Jana. We took a picture together, and I was yelling, "This is my teacher!" and stuff like that. But it was just something about her. It was the skin color, it wasn't that, because my second favorite is Sona. But it was just that. Elegance about her that just drew me near her, that I loved it so much.
Yep. Well, I think you may have been the first Karma I ever saw. I don't know. Is Karma another one of these that's not one of the more popular cosplays? I haven't seen too many of them.
I wasn't the first one. I was actually the second one. my friend Kira, who is, I think it's something Cobra. I forget her name. I'm sorry, Kira, if I don't get your cosplay name.
Violet Cobra?
Violet Cobra, yes.
Yeah. Yeah, Danielle's on the money.
She is. She knows everybody. She did Karma a week before I did. She premiered Karma at Anime Expo. And I was like, oh my God, yes, someone else likes Karma. I was so happy about it. I never say that I'm never like the person that's like, oh, you can't cosplay that because I did it better. I hate people like that, honestly. I think that's a way of bullying and a way of being a poor representative of this community. So when someone says, I'm going to cosplay Kara, I had a guy on DeviantArt that was like, I want to cosplay Kara just with you. I'm like, go for it. I want you to. Go for it. I love the enthusiasm for this champion, that people actually love her, even though they're like, oh, who's Karma? Or she must be a new champion. Or I get all the jokes in like person and on my page. It's like, hey, you know what? If you don't like her, you don't like her. I understand. But she's my champion. And she, if I was a summoner, I would use her for every lane.
Yeah, as someone in chat commented, she is quite the ARAM. ARAM, I was going to say pick, but it's really just a random. You're not really picking anything in ARAM. Very cool.
Nick's the one that said that.
Huh?
I think Nick's the one that said that. He loves Karma.
Is that him?
Yeah.
She's OP, along with Sona. Her, Sona, and Janna are like, don't mess with them.
Very cool. So you kind of mentioned in there that one of the things you like about Karma and what attracted you to her wasn't the skin color. And I want to pull up just this picture again. Karma is a black champion, correct? Is she? Some of the pictures, and some of these she looks just a little tan, and others I
think she's supposed to be Indian.
Really? Is that part? I don't know the lore surrounding her at all, so.
I actually had a controversy behind that because when Kira's picture was uploaded on the League of Legends page, and this is going to be, you're going to hear some words that we that are going to be said. They were dropping M-bombs to say she shouldn't cosplay Wukong and stuff like that. So I took it upon myself to see, look, is she a black champion or not? I was curious. Mm-hmm. So I emailed Riot, and I still have the email, and I got an email from Vladimir, which whoever knows the name Vladimir knows who I'm talking about. I said, look, is Karma a black champion? And he sent me a message back, and I still have it, saying, yes, Karma is indeed a black champion. She is a woman of color.
Wow.
So I was like, thank you. And I posted it. It was spread around Reddit. It was spread everywhere. Some people were calling it fake. I'm like, I can pull up the email. Don't go there. I can pull up the email. So... And it was one of those moments where I wasn't doing it to prove that she was a black champion. I was doing it to show that you got people on the internet. I mean, you guys are harsh. I give it to you. I don't take it to heart, but I like to prove you guys wrong. That's my satisfaction into it.
Yeah.
And when we found that, when I found out, I was like showing people, it was just one of those moments where I was just like, so it was great.
Yeah. Well, when you have an official Riot-stamped email that says, hey, guys, guess what? Guess what? I was right. That's right. That's a cool feeling. One of the topics we wanted to talk about tonight is what it's like to be an African-American cosplayer, because especially in the League of Legends community, that's a little bit of a rarity. You're in the minority that is just cosplay in general, and then another minority on top of that. What's that like? Do you feel like it's a little harder for you, as you were saying? Are you naturally just every time you upload a picture attacked maybe more than some of the rest of us? Although I think everyone here has been victim to the trolls of the internet. We've talked about the infamous bullies that go after Danielle, comparing her Zyras and Amy and Bonnie. I know you guys have some fans out there that aren't really fans. I don't know. I consider trolls almost like fans because they put in so much time to make you feel so bad about yourself. They kind of have to be a fan to some degree. I mean, shit, they're looking at you. Isn't that the whole point of it?
Haters make you famous.
That's what I'm talking about. Paris Hilton.
Haters make you famous. And I always go by that analogy. And yes, it is hard as an African-American to cosplay in the League of Legends community. As I said before, I will drop some words that will probably be really, really offensive, but it's going to have to be said because that's what I got. When my picture was posted on Elo Hell. Oh, Elo Hell.
I think Danielle knows about that all too well.
Of Riot. When it was posted on Elo Hell, I got like... in words, I got coon, I got like a lot of negativity saying, oh, she's fat, and oh, Karma's fed, and oh, black people shouldn't cosplay this, and oh, not Asian enough. And I was just sitting there looking at it. I'm just like, attention, 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 attention. You're taking the time to sit there and look at my cosplay, and try to critique it. But all you're doing is giving the person publicity in the end. Because I was like, I literally was trolling them back. I said, okay, you know what? I'll eat more if I'm so fat. I like my size. I like my curves. I don't care what you think. And they're like, oh, you're too dark. Okay, I was just at the beach. I'm sorry. They're like, oh, her breasts are too big, or oh, this, or oh, that. I was like, my breasts are too big. From what guy says that? And so it's just you try to troll somebody. Make sure you're actually trying to like not get counter trolled, because when you get counter trolled, it's gonna hurt. And it's not hurting me, because one, I don't know you. Two, I probably will never meet you. Three, you're not someone of importance in my life. And four, what are you going to do about it? Deal with it.
Yeah. Well, how about you guys, Bonnie and Amy? I mean, you guys get extra hate for your ethnicity? Or is there a lot of Asian hate on there? I'm sure there are some offensive terms people could bring out against Asians, huh?
Yeah, I mean, I've heard people say Riven is not Asian, but who cares?
She is now.
Yeah, she is now. That's true. What you gonna do about it?
Is it really note? I mean, I don't really look at the hero or the champion's races. I don't really zoom in on them that frequently. But I mean, are they detailed enough that you can clearly see the Asian champions from the Caucasian champions from the Indian champions from the? I mean, are they? I mean, we're talking about like pixels here. Are they really that?
I think if people have to message Riot and ask for their race, I don't think it's very clear what their races are.
That's a good point.
I think, like, most of the races are, like, people kind of discern the information from their lore and also, like, their names. Like, I know a lot of the community thinks that Karma is Indian because her name is Karma. Mm-hmm. And Ari is obviously Korean because, like, Riot kind of released her development story. She, you know, she was released as a part of, I think, the Korean servers. Opening. So, yeah, I don't think you'd actually be able to tell from any of the art.
Right.
I mean, Rise is purple. You can clearly tell he's purple.
Yeah, and I don't know what ethnicity that is. Who are the purple people?
Yeah, I don't know. They're probably like a race of alien or something. I don't know.
Their own breed, their own thing. But I guess everybody gets hate. I don't know. We don't need to pull an Al Sharpton here and turn this into a racial slugfest. But ELO Hell, we talked about this a little bit last week, not in the show, but actually in the post game. I think right after our show ended last week, Danielle realized that her Galio had been put up on ELO Hell, and that became our post cosplay room talking point. What the fuck is ELO Hell, and what do they do? As far as I can tell, their website has nothing to do with ELO Hell. It's like totally rad, but for League of Legends, I guess. Is that it?
Bad place to go.
Who runs it? Who's the guy that owns that shit? Let's go beat him up or something, you know?
I don't like ELO Hell because he steals pictures. He doesn't give credit at all.
Yeah.
To be fair, the guy who runs it is actually quite nice.
Oh, you know him?
I think he's actually friends with a lot of the cosplayers. He's quite friendly and professional. I don't think it's entirely his fault that ELO Hell just kind of attracts the scumbags of the league.
Actually, a lot of the mean comments on my Galio were deleted. Really? So I don't know if he deleted them or if the people were so sick of people being mean to them over their mean comments that they deleted their own.
I don't know. I don't know much about this site. I discovered it last week when Danielle was talking about it. So I'm a little out of my element here. But is it just a blogging site and they just post? I mean, is it a cosplay site or is it everything League? I mean, what is the?
It's more of a content site. People like whatever happens. It's all, when you go to the page, you like submit content. So people will submit content from other people, which in my opinion, I think that's not fair because the person that either did the art did the creation, did the cosplay, are not getting credited for it. Right. So I think that's why a lot of people are kind of turned off by Elo Hell, because there's no credit given for these people submitting it. It's not the person that created the site's fault. Mm-hmm. It's the people that are submitting the things that are being uploaded. It's community, and the community fucking sucks.
It sounds to me that it's kind of like a Reddit for League of Legends. Is that sort of a fair comparison? Like what Reddit does and how they don't really create any content. It's just sharing other content that's already been produced. Is that close?
Yeah, you can look at it that way.
You can. Just putting it in terms that I can understand. I don't know, I spend too many hours every day on Reddit, and I don't even like Reddit that much.
Yeah, you don't even know how to spell karma.
Oh my god, that was every week, every fucking week when we make that little flyer, you know, of like who our guest is going to be, every week I fuck something up, and I don't know what it is. I misspell something, or I write the person's name wrong. It's so embarrassing. I think I'm 3 for 3 so far that something's been messed up. And I even took 10 minutes to look at it and go, this bitch is perfect. Nobody, like, it's becoming a thing that I don't want to be a thing. So frustrating, so frustrating. So Tiffany, talk to us about the rave scene a little bit. And this is something that was new to me that I discovered at KatsuCon of this year in February. When I hear the word rave, I wish I had a video to play. My definition of rave is not what they do at anime conventions. First of all, I guess explain the wardrobe. The big leg warmers and the synthetic dreads that I find a little bit offensive because I've got some real dreads going on. You know, see all these girls putting on these fake dreads, I don't know, with glow sticks in them. And I guess everybody just goes to the rave and dances. I don't know. Break it down for us. Have any of the other three of you participated in said rave culture that we're talking about? Does anyone else have a frame of reference here?
I've been to raves, but I haven't dressed for them.
Okay. All right. Amy, Bonnie, any rave action?
No.
Not really.
Yeah, I just started going to conventions, like, not too long ago, and I actually didn't know that conventions were, like, a social thing until I think PAX East. Mm-hmm. Like the first couple of conventions I went to, I just kind of like stuck with my friends and didn't really meet people. And I didn't know that like people went out afterwards to party. Like I feel like I've been stuck under a rock this entire time. And only at PAX East did I discover that, oh my God, conventions are actually kind of fun.
Yeah. I had a different definition in my head of what a rave is. Although I've never really been to a rave before, so what I have in my head could just be total bollocks. But Tiffany, let me scroll to this picture. Break it down for us. What's it all about, and is there significance to, are those fangs that you're wearing there? And I see all sorts of stuff in your hair. Break it down for us.
That was for a cosplay fashion shoot, and I had to, they gave us a theme that we had to work on, and mine was like vampire. So I thought of making a thing where I'm a huge fan of Queen of the Damned, the book, not the movie. So I like the movie, but I like the book. A book is a lot better, trust me. So when I was thinking about it, I was like, okay, so maybe I'll go with a little bit of red, get the cliche colors, and then we'll put a little gold into it, make it like an Egyptian thing, because my heritage is partially Egyptian. So when we did the picture, he was like, can you show your fangs a little bit? And it was just like, they're like retractable fangs. Like if you ever watch True Blood and stuff like that, they like,
I love
they like
True
click.
Blood.
They click, you like basically apply pressure to the tongue, and then they click out, just like in the show.
Yeah, I've seen those.
So, it was basically for a fashion show. As for the rave scene, I go to raves once in a while. It depends on the convention. Mm-hmm. Otakon's rave is fucking crazy. It's awesome.
The one at KatsuCon was a little disappointing. I went in there with one of my friends. I mean, I like to dance a little bit, and I couldn't get into the music. It was way, I don't know, man. It was just not dance music. It was too fast. The beat, it had to have been like 200 beats per minute, and I don't know how you're supposed to dance to that. My body doesn't gyrate that quick. I don't know.
It really depends on, like, the style of dancing. There's industrial, there's happy, there's things like that. But, yeah, I don't go to KatsuCon's rave. It's no offense to KatsuCon. It's just the area that they have the rave in I don't like. And then the rules that they have applying to it. Because they don't let you take bags in. And I have to have my cell phone on me constantly in the case my little guy is sick or something while I'm at a convention. But Otakon's rave is fan-freaking-tastic. It's really fun, in my opinion. I probably won't be raving because I have like photo shoots lined up at night, especially for Karma, because I'm going to be putting LED lights in the sleeves, hopefully, if I can get that done. Mm-hmm. But it's more fun to me at Otakon's rave. You can ask anyone comparing some raves to each other. Anime USA rave was pretty fun. I went to Anime Boston's rave. That was pretty decent. And then, you know, it really depends. And the style of dance depends on what you like to do. You can dance fast. You can actually dance slow to a fast song.
Yeah.
It really depends on your style of dancing. I mean, no one really cares. Ravers are just like,
yeah.
It's all about feeling the music without, you know, that whole cliche of every raver does ecstasy or drugs or stuff like that. And that's why I prefer conventions over actual going to a rave, because yes, they are a lot safer and you have that less chance of something bad happening, especially to us ladies.
I know Anime Boston's rave has been canceled because last year somebody was giving out bad E and a bunch of like underage kids overdosed.
Oh my god. Mm-hmm. I haven't gone to Anime Boston one in like 5 years.
Was it last year or the year before? But yeah, they were giving out bad E.
Don't those kids know you're supposed to bring your own drugs, not get them from others? Jeez. Jeez. All I'm saying is I would not take random pills from some strange kid at a convention. Just like, here, man, it's ecstasy. Go crazy. I'd be like, this could be anything. It could be aspirin or it could be rat poison, man. I don't know. That's some scary shit. But I guess that's true, though. And in my mind, what I was saying about kind of when someone says a rave, what I first think of, I picture everybody rolling on ecstasy, like just crazy glow sticks and just, I don't know, not a... I know what you mean about the Katsukon rave where it's in, I don't know, it just, I don't know the right word. Just, you walk in and you're just like, this is just a big empty convention hall with a couple people dancing. This isn't a rave. This isn't, I don't know. I don't know what it was. It was just weird. I felt bad not being able to get into the music. But I'm excited now. You filled me with hope that Otakon will reignite my rave excitement. I don't know. I'll give it a chance. I also saw one guy at Katsukon. Huh? Go ahead, Danielle.
Are you going to wear fuzzy stuff?
I don't know. Explain the fuzzy stuff. What's with the leg warmer?
I'm not sure.
I thought that shit died in the 80s. What happened?
No. You guys think of rave attire almost like cosplay. There's like, you know, people... There's one cosplay raver that I just think she's fan-freaking-tastic. I forgot her name off the top of my head. But I have a lot... I really did. It's like... I'm not on the ball with my cosplay friends right now, but her rave attire, man, it's just like, she is beautiful. She has like all these LED lights and stuff, so she makes herself the center of the freaking attention. It's like, you can't go past anyone without seeing her in the ceiling reflecting off her lights. I'm just like, holy crap. But she's amazing. It's all about, it is almost like a style thing. And I want to say that very loosely, because, and... with rave attire, it's either like you want to dance, you want to feel comfortable,
right?
And leg warmers are, in my opinion, are very comfortable to dance in while wearing like, you know, short shorts or something like that without being, you know, completely exposed.
Yeah, well, that's true.
So, and I when I dress in raves, I either wear a skirt or shorts, and it's very rare that I actually do dress up in raves now because I'm getting older. And I feel like the old lady at cons, but I never tell my age because they're just like, oh, you're this age? I'm like, yeah, I'm pretty old. So, but no one can, but like I said, no one can tell when I go to raves how old I truly am. So that's why I'm actually starting to get out of the rave scenes, get more into photography and modeling and stuff like that. So it's all about style, in my opinion, with rave clothing.
All right. The rave at Katsukon, I remember seeing a guy that was in the hallway outside of the rave, and he just had a big boombox, and he was just outside dancing by himself. And I thought once the rave started, he would move inside, but he just kept on going. He had his own party outside, and I did not get it. I felt like he had to be, like, role-playing a character or something that really likes to dance. He had a headband on. He didn't look normal. Or he was just on drugs. I can't tell. It was weird. I watched him for a good half hour, and he just kept doing it over and over. He's one of those people, he would make eye contact with you, and then he would just keep going. He no shame. It was the weirdest thing I've ever seen. Hoping to see it again at Otakon. wow. Wow, well, that got me all pumped up to dance now. I'm going to go check out the rave. The other thing that I don't get with raves, this is just a personal off-topic. I always wonder what the touching rule is, you know, because I've been to concerts where, you know, you're shoulder to shoulder, you're touching everybody around you, right? And I've been to, like, electronica concerts where it's like that, too. You're in the pit and everyone's just, you know, rubbing up on each other. At KatsuCon, it wasn't like that. Everybody had their own little space bubble and they're just getting down on the dance floor. Is there touching at Otakon? Because I'll be honest, I prefer a little bit of touching. When there's enough space that everybody has their own space cushion, it's kind of weird. I feel like I have there's too much opportunity for me to make a fool out of myself. The closer the space, the harder it is to really do something stupid.
I have my own personal rule. If you touch me in an indecent way, I will knock you out and I will go to jail.
I don't mean that kind of touching. And you're like, there's just not enough room for everybody to move around without touching each other. Shoulder to shoulder. You know, I'm not talking about, like, inappropriate groping and stuff. Jesus.
Oh, Tiffany.
That does happen, though. And that's happened to me before. And I literally, like, turned around and, like, nailed him one. But it does happen when people are, like, dancing and they dance. You feel back-to-back or you feel shoulder to shoulder or things like that. It's nothing wrong with that. But some guys and girls, it's not just guys, it is girls, will get touchy-feely and will go that distance and be inappropriate. And if people know me that I'm a nice person in real life. You know, people know me as a sweetheart. But if you do something very inappropriate around me that can possibly turn into something that it should not be, I'm from D.C. I will turn into that Southeast D.C. girl. And I will tell you about yourself, and I will embarrass you because it's not right for people to go through that, to have that line crossed, to be inappropriately touched. But our Otakon raves are very, I've never heard any bad stories of anybody being bad touched. So, it's more of you're going to feel shoulders, you're going to feel backs, you're going to maybe feel a chest bump against you. But you might have a dance partner randomly. It happens. But it's the feeling of the music. It's the flow of the music that you're feeling in your body. It just makes you want to dance. And whoever's is around you is just not even there. It's just, for me, I love rave music. I love it. I listen to it every time I play League. I'm going to hopefully start streaming soon when I do it and just play rave music. People are going to be like, why do you always play rave music? And I'm like, I love it. I can't help it. So It's basically, you have no worries for Otakon. If something does bad happen, tell me and I will talk to the staff immediately. Trust me, I will.
are you an employee for Otakon? Will you be doing staff this year?
No,
you just got the in, so all right, you're the go-to person. All right, good. If I get in trouble, I'll shoot you a text. I'm in trouble, I need help, Tiffany. Rescue me from the dance floor.
I'm a nice girl that basically will help friends out. I don't want my friends to never have a bad experience at a convention. KatsuCon, we had a lot of trouble. We had another con there. Hold on for a second. My son lost his teeth today, so he wants to keep the door open for the tooth fairy. So I'm telling him.
That's so adorable.
So he's like, we had an issue at KatsuCon where, there was another convention there. It was a Jewish convention. So us cosplayers, I was telling friends, you know what, make them feel comfortable. Don't incite anything bad. Don't do this. Don't do that. Just be normal people. But we had a lot of hostility. There was props broken. There was a girl sexually assaulted. I took it upon myself to talk to the hotel staff. And I said, this should not happen next year. If I find out they come back next year, we're going to have issues. And I'm like 5'1". I will make myself known to people saying that this is inappropriate. This should not be happening. We should have a peaceful settlement between two different conventions. Honestly, we were being the peacekeepers. We were called everything but a child of God at that convention. But you know what? Every time I saw one of them and they was looking at my props, I said, you want to look at it? He goes, yeah, I want to check it out. And there was a guy who wanted to go into the dealer's room and he couldn't go into the dealer's room. I said, do you see anything that you like? And he goes, oh, I see that. I was like, okay, can you trust me to give me the money and I will go buy it for you? So he did. So I went in there, I bought the item, brought it back out. I said, here you go. He goes, you guys are really nice. I was like, we try to be. We're not freaks. We're just people that just love to dress up and just enjoy ourselves.
Someone in chat Tekkenator is saying that that Jewish group is actually banned from the Gaylord after KatsuCon because of their conduct. He says, quote, they did hotel damage on the floors they stayed at as well. I did not know that. I was on the opposite side. I was with a group of people, and every time we bumped into them, they just yelled out JewCon, and a lot of the Jewish folks did not find that very appropriate. So I spent my time running away from a lot of the Jewish people because I didn't want to be associated with the individual member of my party that thought it was funny to laugh at them. But wow, I didn't realize that. Someone was sexually assaulted? Tiffany, that's terrible.
It was terrible. That's the story that I heard, but I can't really go by stories. I was going by personal experiences that I and my friends were dealing with, and you don't mess with my friends at conventions. And I will, like I said, I've made myself known. Even Yaya Han was like, this is unacceptable. And I was like, when Yaya Han says something is unacceptable, the hotel's just like, okay, let's go. So it's just like, it was one of those moments where they were, it was almost a bad experience. People didn't want to come back next year. And I was just like, guys, you cannot go by this experience for a convention because it wasn't something we expected. I think next year the hotel will learn that if a big con like KatsuCon is coming, because it's a photography dreamland at KatsuCon, the areas are just so. I think next time they're gonna just be like, yeah, let's just make it just their con, hopefully.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I recall seeing the drunk Thor fall in the fountain. That was quite humorous. That was, KatsuCon was okay, but yeah, it was weird seeing the different conventions, and I've had that a few times where the conventions in the same place are totally different. One time when I was at an MLG, there was a horror convention in the hall right next door, which was kind of weird. I mean, people just dressed up like creepy characters and all tricked out in all sorts of gory makeup. It was a weird mix. Seeing the two interface together was just, you couldn't write that shit, man. Is everyone still there? It's awfully quiet.
Hello? Yes.
Okay, good. Okay. Jesus. That was just a second of pure silence where I was just like, wait.
Thank you. That's why.
I was expecting
the city to... Yeah, am I still on the internet here? Okay. Okay, cool. I had a thought, and again, I'm like extra forgetful today. I don't know what my deal is. That's what it was. Guys, remember, feel free to tweet questions at us or post in the Twitch chat. We will spend the last 5 minutes or so doing Q&A for our hosts as well as our guests. So remember to throw those questions out there. We love Q&A, and we love each and every one of you. So one of the last big topics we want to try and tackle tonight, Tiffany, and we've tackled a handful of them. I want to talk about crossplay a little bit, because you did that Nick Fury cosplay, which was interestingly fabulous. Let me scroll to it here so folks can look at it. And I absolutely love the picture of you laying on your side with the bullet holes in the camera. That is one of the slickest cosplay pictures I have seen this side of the Mississippi.
Yeah, that was done by my good friend SF Designs. I'm gonna promote him right now. That was done by a good friend of mine named SF Designs, and we've been doing. I met him last year at Otakon, and he was just a newbie photographer. And then we were like, oh, we're doing something for KatsuCon, blah 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 blah. Now he's gonna be the photographer doing this big League of Legends photo shoot that it's gonna be a big project that I'm personally taking on. And me and him are taking on to submit to whatever, just to show different League cosplayers from different parts of the United States. Hopefully, if I can get the funding to do this. But he did that picture. It was originally at night at KatsuCon. Backdrop was perfectly dark. It's not edited. It was actually that dark at the time. We were there at like 10 o'clock. And...
Oh, okay.
So when he did that shot, he was like, I want you to lay on your side and imagine that you're pissed off at someone. And I was like, well, I can't imagine that I'm pissed off at someone. He goes, well, someone stole your 3DS. I'm like, someone never touches my 3DS. So it was just like, I was just basically like, he go, believe that you're shooting that person to get your stuff back. And I was like, okay.
Wow.
So when he edited the picture, he was like, what do you think about this? I was like, oh my God, that looks great. It looked fantastic. I was just like, oh. And that was the first time I actually crossplayed. I do plan on doing, I will say this out loud, I do plan on doing Lucian. I'm actually going to be shaving the sides of my heads to actually, and then putting the little things into it with the braids going down. Mm-hmm. I will be crossplaying a female version of Lucian. So,
What is Lucian from? I'm sorry.
He's the awesome new ADC.
Oh, Jesus.
He's a new black champion.
So embarrassed. Like, he's in League of Legends and I didn't even know. God.
He's on the PBE. He's not in the game yet. He's on the public test server. He was actually leaked about a month and a half ago, I want to say. And when he was leaked, there was like, oh my god, a male black champion. And I was like, oh my god, a male black champion. Like, everyone was like, Riot is getting ethnic on this now. So when I saw him, I was like, okay, he has elite, he has guns that glow, blah blah blah. But the comments are just so great. They're like, they gave a black man guns. I was like, yes, they gave a black man guns. But he's actually, his lore is really good. Like, it's what he's basically, his wife was taken from him. He hunts people from the Shadow Isles. I think if anyone thinks I'm getting this wrong, please tell me.
Somebody linked a picture of him. So here's a decent, if you want to go to the Twitch chat, somebody linked it. And I see him. It's a black man with some guns. You were exactly right on that. He's got some big guns.
Private Kaiser is an actual good friend of mine. He's doing Lucian. He just linked his progress pictures on the chat.
Well, there you go.
He's going to be Lucian on Friday, and he's going to be Tyrant Swain on Saturday, which is my favorite Swain skins. I love Swain, too.
It looks like Lucian's got some dreads going on, too. I can get behind that.
Yeah, he has, like, that's why I'm going to shave my head, because I don't think you can actually wig that, so I'm just going to actually commit to the cosplay and shave the sides of my head and braid my hair and get extensions in the back.
Some of the Vi's that we've seen recently have shaved half their head.
Wow.
That's some dedication.
Sean is in here too. I see Sean in here. He's doing a male bi. He's cross-playing male bi, so.
Yeah, he's coming to us.
I see him now. I'm not looking at the chat, guys. I'm sorry.
I've been looking at the chat a lot because, Tiffany, you've just been talking so much. We've had, like, nothing to do.
I'm sorry.
No, it's a good thing. Shut up. I don't like talking.
Oh damn, that was a little backhand there. Jeez, got some sass going on.
It's a good thing.
Yeah, Danielle, you might want to go a little closer to your mic there. You sound like far away man again. There you
go. We'll go now.
Oh, that's beautiful. Loud and clear.
I'll just hold it.
Cool. That's what she said. Okay, so how is the crossplay arena? I mean, is it a lot different? Do people are people confused? Right, they're like, so you just got a gun, or are you supposed to be somebody? Is it how's that dynamic? Is it a lot different from doing a non-crossplay cosplay?
It really depends on, like, the characters that you pick. It, like, when I was walking around Katsukata's Nick, they were like, oh, Colonel Fury, you look a lot sexier than usual. And I was like, oh, hello. But it's more the, if you crossplay, I'm not saying this has to be done. It's all up to you, honestly. Make it so that people recognize what you're doing, because some people who crossplay get offended when the people don't recognize what you're doing. Mm. And like, I saw a crossplay, it's on tip of my tongue. It's a DC character. It was a crossplay.
Batman.
No, it was. I'm a Batman fan. I would never not know what a Batman is. It was a crossplay. Oh no, it was a crossplay. Emma Frost. That's not DC. That's Marvel. Tiffany, you are bad. It was a crossplay. Emma Frost. And I didn't really know what the character was. I didn't know who he was. And I looked down, and it was one of those crossplays where he was, like, really exposed. So I was looking down at his crotch area, and I saw the X-Men sign. I was like,
oh,
you're Emma Frost. Hi. So he was in all white. But I couldn't tell because, like, Emma has the X-Men sign on her, you know, belt. And when I it was awkward me just, like, you know, being like, oh, hi, how are you doing, blah, blah, blah. He's like, oh, hi, Nick Fury, blah, blah. And I looked down, and I'm like, staring at his junk, and I see the X-Men sign. I'm like, oh, okay, cool. I know who you are now. But it's one of those things where if you're going to do it, make sure you get the character that, you know, is somewhat, make it close to the attire. I know I didn't make it close, but people recognize the trench coat and the eye patch. Mm-hmm. So it was more like, if you're going to do it, try to get it to the character and don't get offended if someone doesn't recognize you, because I'm a personal person that cannot stand that, especially people who do original characters, and I have nothing against original characters either, but when you get offended saying that, oh, this is my original character, blah, 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 it's not from anything. People are just asking where you're from because they're amazed by the outfit, not offending you or anything like that. They just want to know where you're from. Just don't get offended.
Yeah. Well,
I was actually surprised that when I gender bent Galio, a lot of people knew who it was, and I didn't expect it at all. I was ready to explain it all day.
Really? You didn't think people would recognize Galio? I thought that. I mean, who else could you be?
I just expected them to think I was
Dragon
Demona or whatever her name is from the Gargoyles.
Oh,
looks nothing like Demona.
I know. I got it like twice.
Dragon.
Dragon,
hey, you random dragon lady. How you doing, Anixia?
Well, it could be like an original character or something, but yeah, a lot of people knew who it was. A lot of people were like, this is a really random guess, but are you Galio? And I'm like, yeah. I didn't think that was that random.
Yeah, oh, this is the time. Danielle, we're going to roll. We have a little bit of a little fanfare. Danielle was in a video from Kineticon, and we're talking about Galio. Let's go ahead and roll it. And let's see here. Oh, look at this. Beautiful. So this is stone form Galio right here. Danielle made a careful effort. No, this guy lied. There actually is a foot shot in here.
Yeah, you can see my feet. He said my feet wouldn't be in it, so I didn't have to put the chicken feet on. But they are in it.
And that's that is a foot if I ever saw one. That Kevin, you son of a bitch.
It's so good, though.
It really is.
Oh, my God.
Yeah. Well... So
the
a short
wings
little
are all
clip.
Bent and broken. I just fixed them.
Oh. whoops. Let me run back to the cams here. So I'm glad I meant to play that way at the beginning, and I just totally forgot and just remembered from all the Galio talk. So Danielle, I mean, you have a gender bend crossplay experience. Amy, Bonnie, either of you guys, have either of you considered doing a crossplay? And on the same token, have you ever been deterred from doing a cosplay that you thought would be very interesting based on the fact that it would have to be a crossplay?
Not yet.
Not
Amy wants to do swing?
Bonnie, that's supposed to be a secret. What the hell? I was going to be all like, oh, I have this secret cosplay plan and we're going to see what it is. But now thanks to Bonnie, everybody knows what it is.
I'm hiding.
Secret's out.
Yeah, secret's out.
Damn. Just got outed on the cosplay room.
What the hell?
I didn't even know Swain was a boy.
Swain's an old dude.
Is he? Oh, well.
He's awesome. He has a pimp cane.
He's pretty sweet. He's like everything that I'm not, though. He's like really tall, he's old, he's bald, he's a dude. But I main Swain for a lot. It's not set in stone yet. I'll decide after PAX Prime. But
okay.
It's been on my secret cosplay list. That's no longer a secret anymore. Why don't you just tell him everything else that's on my list, Bonnie?
Tell him what she ate this morning.
I know. Tell him what I'm wearing.
Cheerios. I see what you mean about Swain, though. He is kind of an old dude with a bird. That would be a tough one. All right, so Bonnie, let's kick it to you now. Have you not done something because specifically of the gender or just a cosplay that you liked that you were just like, I'm not an old bald dude. I don't think I could pull that off. Have you had that? You're muted, Bonnie. We can't hear you. It's like you're talking and we can't hear it.
Sorry, I mute my mic. No, I was thinking like after KO I might do like something different, you know, because I do like to do armor and a lot of male champions has armor, so I might do cosplay.
No, Bonnie, you could be a pretty slick Garen if you put your mind to it.
Yeah, you know, I don't play Garen, but I might think of something else.
Garen? Yeah, well, I don't know. He's just so noble. I'd like to see an Asian Garen. That would be cool.
Oh, there's plenty.
There's plenty of Asian Garens. Actually, I guess he's pretty popular. All right. A female Asian Garen.
Maybe.
All right. Well, guys, we've got about 5 minutes left here. It's time for Q&A. I saw one question that I pulled out of chat. I hope at least one other person posts a question. Tweet or post. I'm so eager to answer questions. Here we go, guys. Is it hard to transport yourselves to events? Who wants to tackle it? Go at it.
I guess, because, like, we have to rent a 12-person cargo van to get to Otakon, and we're shoving, like, 6 or 7 people in it, as well as, like, a giant Maokai costume, a giant Fullmetal Jace costume, the Galio wings, and whatever else people are bringing.
Wow. That's, yeah. We talked about that a little bit last week, I think, when we had Brian, or maybe whenever we had Brian on, I've already forgotten, about transporting and moving all that stuff. I still don't, I want to get a picture of your car right as you guys pull up, of just like 6 people all jammed into 2 seats in the front, and then all the rest of the seats of the van are just costumes, because you don't want to damage your wings, or everyone's got all these elaborate pieces that is more important than the comfort of the long trip it takes to get to Otakon.
It's going to take us 6 hours, but I think half the van will be props and half the van will be people. I don't think it'll be too.
Don't forget our clothes.
Clothes?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Don't bring suitcases, bring backpacks so we can kind of shove them better.
All right. That's good to know. Amy, you're planning on PAX Prime. You're in the Boston area. That's a long flight getting over to Seattle. How are you planning on bringing your whole NAMI ensemble? I know you mentioned that it comes apart, but, I mean, are you paying extra for carry-on bags? Are you just going to be that person that takes up the whole overhead bin? What's the plan?
How about all of the above? I'm gonna try and avoid shipping stuff, because that would mean that I would have to finish things like 2-3 weeks in advance, which is probably not gonna happen. Mm-hmm. But I'm definitely looking at getting extra checked bags. I'm trying to make stuff out of squishy materials so I can kind of pack them into suitcases.
Oh, okay, that's an interesting thought. But I guess you're right. Some materials are a little more malleable than others, so you can kind of, you know, jam them in and not have to worry about them breaking. The weapon is the biggest part, because it's a weapon, and you can't bring weapons on airplanes. That makes me nervous.
I mean, at least NAMI doesn't have a sword or anything. Her weapon is like a rounded circular staff thing.
Hey,
so.
Listen, man, they told me that I could do damage with my toenail clippers. I'm pretty sure I could fuck somebody up with that staff. I'm just saying.
Oh my God.
I'm just saying. You know, comparing and contrasting, but yeah, that driving definitely makes things a little easier than flying. You know who would be a good guest to ask about that? Miss Yuru, because she goes to every fucking convention, and she's got some of the most intricate cosplays, and I wonder how she gets all that shit across the country all the time.
I think she ships stuff.
She
does.
Yeah.
She ships her stuff. It's very smart, too, because all you do is just pack your stuff in, you ship it to the location, you pick it up, and then you're good.
Yeah.
Then you ship it back home.
Oh, look at the kitty. That is one large feline. Oh, little whiskers there. Look at that. Awesome.
So bad.
So.
Yeah, the smoke.
So I did see one other question here. This is actually a good one. One that I would not have thought of myself, and I like how they labeled it question in all caps before we got started. Would any of you consider doing a fursuit? Examples, Werwick, Cougar Nidalee, Dragonform, Shyvana. Anybody trying to wear a fursuit?
I would totally do a fursuit.
Yeah, I want to do.
I always tell Nick all the time, oh, I want to be a furry every time we see him walking around conventions. They're so cool.
I don't necessarily know if I want to do a fursuit, but I do want to cosplay Rengar, like, really bad. He's my favorite cat champion. It's like, every time you can ask Johnny, he's like, every time I play him, I always do, like, his theme song very loudly over Skype. And he's like, can you please stop doing the drops? I'm like, duh, 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 duh. And when I kill somebody, I'm like, I'm a kitty. So it's just like, he's one of my favorite top and jungle champions. Like, I really want to do a fursuit, but I think with my condition, it would not be possible. I'll probably die in a suit.
Yeah, that.
Yeah,
that's,
I'd probably pass out too.
Yeah, I see Nick in chat saying that, as he put it, you complain about, what did he say here? Complain about wearing a bikini in summer, let alone a fursuit. Have fun. GG.
It was not a bikini. It was like a full Zentai suit with the front cut out. and I overheated. But yeah, I would probably overheat in a fursuit, but I can still admire them.
Yeah, when we were talking about Nidalee, just it reminded me of I posted another cosplay spotlight this morning, and the girl that I interviewed at Anime Next, she's a new cosplayer, and I was asking her about why she chose Nidalee. She was like, "Well, she's so cute. She's got that like cougar form," and I was just like, "That is the cutest thing I've ever heard. You chose Nidalee because she's got a cute little kitty form. That's so adorable." I still, ever since last week, I feel like I need to do Headhunter Nidalee with the sick dreads and that nice little spear. Speaking of crossplay, what do you think, Tiffany? Could I pull it off?
I think you could.
Wow.
I really think, you know, I'm never a person that says that you can't cosplay this or you can't cosplay that.
All right.
No.
So you might not be the best person to ask. You would have told me anything.
Hey, but you have the hair going on for you, so you are already, like, ahead of all the game, because the hair, the wig is probably the hardest part of the whole set.
It's true.
Yeah, that's true.
Just got to braid them together. Wow. So, all right, guys, we are at the top of the hour. Unless anyone else has something they'd like to add before we go into the shout-out realm. That time, anyone else have a question for Tiffany? Something else I'd like to bring up? Something that we didn't cover? Anything? Last chance. All right, very cool. So shout out time. Tiffany, you're up first. Like I said before, thank you so much for taking the time to join us. You are a fabulous guest. So much to say, so much insight. Do you have any shout outs for us?
I have probably three. I can't say her name right, but she's been like a really a really cheerleader for me for my cosplay. Her name is Sindraladra. If I say your name wrong, I'm sorry, Tough Titty, but I can't do it right. I want to shout out to SF Design, who's been and my son, who's yelling in the background. SF Design has been nothing but an inspiration to make me continue cosplay, because at one point I was getting bullied to the point where in real life, in front of my face, that I wanted to quit. But he was like, "Oh, just toughen up, Tiffany. Just go with it. You're doing great." And I was like, "Okay." I want to give a shout out to Johnny, because he was the person that said I should do cosplaying, because that I always watch videos. He goes, "Oh, you should do that. You should do that." And he was like pushing me. He actually helped me paint these babies at one point. It was giving me advice. He's a fantastic painter. That's the people I can think of on top of it. And Zalgaret. You know who you are, Sean. I can't say your name. MT Host. I see you there, too. So I'm sorry if I missed anybody. I love you guys. You know I do.
All right. Very cool. Danielle, up next. What you got for us this week?
I just wanted to give a shout-out to everybody that's watched all 4 weeks. I've seen a few familiar faces in the chat every week, and I really appreciate it.
I'm always surprised by the lack of Nick shouting out that happens at this point, Danielle.
Nick's right there.
He's right there. He knows he gets the shout out. All right. Amy, what you got for us? Closing words.
Just thanks everybody for watching. I definitely agree with Danielle. I mean, it's really great to see those of you guys who have shown up for every single episode. I mean, like, I know it's an hour out of your day, and it's really nice that you guys come out to support us. So thanks for tuning in this week, and I hope to see you guys next week.
All right, last but not least, Bonnie, what you got for us?
Yeah, thanks for coming to watch us. Like Danielle and Amy said, I appreciate your support. And you should come back and watch again next Monday.
That's the spirit. That's right, guys. Monday nights at 9 o'clock Eastern, 6 o'clock Pacific, and the middle of the night for you European folks that are crazy enough to be watching. Thank you so much for joining us for another installation of the Cosplay Room. We'll be back next week and the week after that. And probably the week after that, and we'll be reporting on Otakon in the weeks to come. So, cheers. Follow all of our hosts. Once again, big shout-out to Tiffany for joining us. Keep the dream alive. That's the spirit. So, until next week, guys, we'll see you.
Bye.
Bye.
Thanks for having me. Bye.
Really sleazy. for sea.